thank you. You've been so kind.
No problem. I didn't catch your name.
It doesn't matter anymore. Goodbye.
That girl looked just like Mabel Norman.
That guy drives just like Barney Oldfield.
Ma'am, I see you made it to 2001.
It's horrible. I want to go home.
You want to go home? I have something that might help. Come here. Take this. You'll find what else you need that way. Good luck.
Not again.
Thank you.
back here. Let me try out there.
Damn thing doesn't work here either.
Hello? Hello?
Damn.
Hello?
Jack, how did this go? How you doing?
Oh, I'm fine, Gerald. Good to hear from you.
Yeah, I just wanted to let you know that I don't have to be in your place until 11:30.
Oh, well, that'll be fine. I have a couple of gold coins I want to show you.
Great. I'm looking forward to seeing them. And I got something really special to show you, too.
Okay, well, I'll see you at about 11:30.
Very good. See you then.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
God, it's cold here.
What about the film that you're doing on Chaplin? What's that?
Film? Oh, do you mean my Chaplin film locations dead and now site?
Yes, that's what
yeah,
I mean.
Yeah, I'm still doing that. You know, I love Charlie as much as I love Edna. I mean, you know, the guy, he was a genius, don't you think?
No question about that, he was a genius. I was just watching Modern Times.
Modern Times?
Yes.
You know, I've been trying to find that ending location for I don't know how long. It must have been 10 or 15 years I'm trying to find that location. Oh, you still got your iBook?
Yeah, yep. All new. But you'd like to see the gold coin?
Oh, absolutely.
Sure. There it is.
That's gorgeous.
Isn't that a beauty? I paid virtually nothing for that coin.
God, looks like it was just minted yesterday.
I know.
1908. That's about as old as you are, Jack.
Well, almost.
That's really nice. Yeah.
But didn't you have something you wanted to show me?
Sure do.
Okay.
This letter is going to knock your socks off.
Really?
I could not believe that I found this. Yes. Huh. 1915?
Yeah.
Dear Charlie, Mr. Charles Chaplin.
Charlie Chaplin?
The one and only.
Oh my.
Dear Charlie, a timely gift for your birthday next week. Huh? I know we've grown apart, but I'm hoping sparks will fly tonight. Love, Mabel. That's got to be Mabel Norman.
Oh my.
Isn't that
Mabel
funny?
Norman?
Yeah.
Oh. Where in the world did you get this letter?
That's a long story, Jack.
Well, let's have lunch. You can tell me about it then.
Sounds good. Can I throw my coat over here?
Sure, right there.
Okay.
Did you pour for us?
Sure. Let me tell you the story about how I found that letter first.
Okay.
You're not going to believe this. I'm telling you. Anyway, a few months back, I was on eBay looking for vintage stuff from the St. Francis Hotel.
Right.
You know how I like that old stuff, right?
Oh, sure.
Well, this letter comes up, and I'm looking at it, and man, stationery looks real. And the handwriting looks just like Mabel Norman's handwriting.
Oh.
So guess what? I call the guy up, and he tells me that while metal detecting, he finds this letter in a silver box buried next to the Portals of the Past.
Portals of the Past, Golden Gate Park?
Golden Gate Park, Portals of the Past. But wait a minute. Then he proceeds to tell me, which this is kind of strange, that he sees a young girl with a gold coin and she disappears in the Portals of the Past.
Oh my. Gerald, this reminds me of my trip up to you in 2001.
Right.
Remember that?
I sure do.
Okay. Coming back home, I picked up this young girl, helped her get back her gold coin and make muff.
A golden coin?
A gold coin. And she looked just like Mabel Norman.
Mabel Norman?
Absolutely. Mabel Norman.
Man, Jack, this is really strange. I mean, I got goosebumps on my body.
Oh, yeah. Me too.
I need a drink.
How about you? Here to it. Cheers.
Well, let me pour it first. I mean, no one's going to believe this. That's the shot I need to find. I've seen that somewhere before. I'll call Jack up.
Hello, Jack.
Yeah, hi, this is Gerald.
Gerald, good to hear from you.
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure that you were still coming up next week.
Yes, I'll be there. Okay. Bye.
Hey, I like your new mustache.
Oh, thank you.
Should we go have a drink before we go to the Portals of the Past?
Sounds great.
Let's go this way here.
Come sit here, Jack. I got three nice cold ones here.
Oh, well, that's really nice, Gerald.
Oh, thanks, Dave.
I can't believe you guys think Mabel Norman's a time traveler.
Well, David, that letter to Charlie is the real thing, you know.
Well, it may be the real thing, but do you ever think that maybe Mabel was just joking around when she wrote it?
I don't think so.
That girl that I picked up and took to the park,
She
looked just like Mabel Norman.
Well, a lot of people look like Mabel Norman, but was she the same height, same build?
She was taller, and she was somewhat larger.
Yeah.
Well, you know, maybe her body changed when she went through time.
Yeah, right. You guys will believe anything.
Hey, look, if you think it's so funny, why don't we just drop you off at the Cliff House, and Jack and I will go to the portals of the past by ourselves.
And have me miss all the fun? Not a chance. I'm not missing this one.
Gerald, yeah. I have the gold coin. We'll prove it to you. Let's go.
Sounds good to me.
You two guys want to go make fools of yourselves, run into the past, go ahead. I'm going to sit here and watch.
Look, David, we're here, we're going to give it a try. We think it's going to work.
Well, I'm not
going to
stop you.
Don't you think, Jack?
Go ahead.
Whatever. Gerald, let's go.
All right, come on. You know, I really think it's going to work, or at least, you know, we can give it a shot anyway.
You know, David thinks that we're a couple of fools, but, you know, the two stories, I mean, they really seem to add up. There's got to be something to this place, you know what I mean?
It happened.
Yeah, I really think it did. So, you know, let's give that gold coin a try, and who knows? Look at that place, wow. Jack, give me that gold coin.
Yeah, there it is.
Wish me luck.
Good luck.
It doesn't work, Jack. It doesn't work. You want to try it?
Yeah.
You kind of wave it around or something? I don't think it works. Well, we gave it a shot anyway. I don't know. Maybe the thing has to be a special coin or something.
I don't know.
I don't know. Yo, David! Quick! I lost Jack! Come on! I can't find him! Jack!
What, is he okay? Did he get hurt?
What? He's gone.
You're right.
I kid you not, he's gone! He took the gold coin back there and he just vanished in the thin air! Look, for Christ's sakes, he's not there!
Well, what'd you do? Where'd he go?
He went through there with a gold coin, I swear to God.
Here we are.
Okay.
Sometimes the gold coin gets a nice laugh.
Yeah, well, you had me going for a second, but are you satisfied it doesn't work? Can we go home now?
Yeah, I guess. That one didn't work, but you know, maybe we need a coin from Mabel Norman.
Yeah, well, maybe you need a coin from Mars, too.
Whatever. It's a mink mop from 1915. I get it on eBay from the Lost and Found Department of the St. Francis. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, it's very nice. How much did you spend for that?
Not that much.
Not that much? $470? You
yeah.
think that's not that much?
Yeah, but it's from 1915.
Oh.
And it's mink.
I'm tired of doing your...
Well, be careful with
it. Then and now stuff.
Well, I'm sorry. Where are you going, honey? Rhea? Are you mad at me? What is this? Mr. Charles Chaplin, Niles?
Looks like it's never been mailed. April 12, 1915. Dear Charlie, on the way to meet you at the Dutch windmill on Friday, something very strange happened. I know you won't believe me, but I traveled to the year 2001. It all started when a strange man gave me a $20 gold piece for a banana. Then I was chased by a tramp through the portals of the past. Next thing I knew, I was in the year 2001, looking at a dilapidated Dutch windmill and discovering that the gold piece was dated 2001. It was a very strange weekend. I was able to return to 1915 when that same strange man gave me a $20 gold piece dated 1915. I know you're laughing your head off right now and thinking about turning my wild story into a photoplay. Please believe me, it really did happen, and I'll never be the same. Please come spend time with me this weekend at the St. Francis. Love, Mabel. This is from Mabel Norman. Jack and I are right about this whole damn thing. What else is in there? Edna Purviance, Belvoir Hotel.
Okay, gotta have money.
This is Gerald. I'm trying to get hold of you, but looks like you're not there. I just wanted to tell you that meat and muffin cone story and that girl in the park, it's all true. And to make a long story short, I'm going back to 1915 right now. I'm in San Francisco, and I'm going to try to go through the portals of the past. And if I don't make it back, you're the best.
How about a little help? Screw you.